cloud. Here we go. Hey, folks, neighbors, Calgarians, it's Brian Howard. And today on the podcast, Living in Calgary Real Estate and Lifestyle, I have my now friend, Jan Demery, on the show. Jan, welcome back. How's it been? You're just a week or two away from becoming our new mayor.
I am saying that more and more. I am the next mayor. It is an amazing adventure.
The power of the mindset. Jan, what have you learned since our last conversation? I think that we spoke, I might've been May or June, and I've been interviewing various mayoral candidates and stuff. And you were my very, very first. I was blessed. I mean, and we live about 10 blocks away. Yes. So it was only fitting that you were my first in terms of this. And tell us some of the things that you've learned, you've seen. Were there any surprises along the trail? And what are we? We're about, I think, 12 days away from Election Day. Yeah. When Calgarians say yes to Jan.
Yeah, it's been an amazing experience. And I think what just has been so just energizing for me is meeting new people. I love to meet new people. Really listen what's on their minds. And we know many of our neighbors and friends, Brian, have really struggled these last 4 years. And they need hope. And they're looking just kind of for just optimism. And they want to feel safer. That's actually been the most surprising. But then when I reflect and think about what we've endured with COVID, how unsettled all of us are, and there needs to be a real commitment, I think, to leadership going forward, a plan that can actually move us out so we can be this amazing city, regain our confidence. That's the leadership I'm offering. And every time I talk with people, I had one of the most profound conversations with a young Asian woman who, she was very quiet on the call. And then she said, you know what, Jan, I'm afraid. And then we talked more about that. And we talked more about my vision for this city. And she said at the end of that conversation, Brian, Jan, I feel less afraid talking to you.
Nice.
That's the power of leadership.
Wow. Fantastic. Cool. And so as you've gone down, I mean, how long has it been since you started thinking about like becoming the leader of our city? Has it been a few years or months?
It's been a year. It's been a year. So that first fateful conversation happened about a year ago.
And what, and then you threw your name into the hat 6 months ago or thereabouts?
May 4th was the day. May the 4th be with you.
May the 4th be with you. And has there been any surprises along the way?
Countless. The big surprise is the roller coaster ride this is. And it often happens, the dips hourly, Brian. You're constantly getting fed with data. You're constantly getting fed with what people like about you, don't like about you. I have an amazing team around me. This too, right, is about leadership. It's never about me. It's about how can I build amazing team that we can accomplish things and how they buffer me, you know, particularly through the ugly, ugly social media comments. As you have gotten to know me, I speak my mind. You know where I stand on things. Apparently a lot of people don't like that.
Wow. Yeah, I just couldn't even imagine like what it would take to like put yourself out in public office like this these days. Yeah.
You poke like, at it. Have you seen our mean tweets? I don't know if you know.
No, I just avoid most of everything.
We've taken a parody of mean tweets. Like it is vile.
Really?
So
you're being teased. What do you mean? Are you having fun with that? Or like, I don't even know what you're talking about.
Having fun with it, right? But you expose it. This is what I've learned. It's hard. Yeah. You know, a lot of this stuff lives in the shadows and we have to expose it. I mean, I'm tough. And I'm very committed to the people of our community, making sure that we build a city where everyone sees opportunity. So that's what fuels me. So I say, bring it on.
Wow. In terms of conversation and where we may go with this, do you have any, I have some thoughts or ideas on where I'd like to go. Where would you like to go? What, in terms of, we got another 5 or 10 minutes. Yeah. What would you like to share with our listeners and primarily our neighbors here in Altidore? Is there anything that you'd like to share, what you're seeing? A slant on why we should be voting for you, Jan? Yeah.
So this is a critical election because we really are talking about the future of our city, about recovery. And what that recovery is going to look at like, and you know, because of the work that I've done in the not-for-profit sector, married with my corporate sector, and I'm a leader and I'm a doer. And it's really critical that people do and get out and vote. But I'm going to encourage them not to be lazy. Don't just go on name recognition. Do your research. And I know it's overwhelming with 28 candidates, but there essentially are two counselors and me in this race. And I'm about fresh perspective. I'm not about bickering politicians. I'm not the politician. I am doing this to serve and get us back on track so that we can actually create a city where there's opportunity. I think we talked about the first time, Brian, one of my key motivators, I've got a stepson, 24, who left this city because he doesn't see opportunity here. I think the Calgary Foundation just came out with a survey today. 30% of people surveyed are thinking about leaving this city. If that is not a crisis or an emergency and a reflection, A, on the times that we're dealing with, but also leadership at City Council, I don't know what is. We need a change. We need a leader. And I'm that leader. No one else can bring us out of this.
Wow. I was kind of happy to hear you say, you know, get out and vote. But along with that, and I hear that over and over again since I was, you know, 18 years old, I suppose. And to me, it's like a little bit overwhelming to like, get out, well, I get out and vote and, oh, here I am at the poll and who the hell do I vote for? So I've kind of, I've missed some elections. Shh, don't tell anybody.
I know.
Like, you know, you say get informed. And so at this point with 12 days left of the race, and you mentioned that there's you and two other candidates, would it be appropriate to bring those names up? Probably not. I don't know. But no, like, how would you do the research?
There's polling now coming. And so you'll see that the leads are, and they're kind of neck and neck, but less than 30% of the vote with a lot of undecided, thinking at least that undecided. And I've been door knocking, many people still undecided. And again, just going with name recognition. Right. So that's Jeremy Farkas and that's Jody Gondek.
Okay.
These are divisive politicians. They have not shown any leadership in the last 4 years at a time when we have been in crisis. We need leadership to come out of this, to create opportunity. I've led all my career across sectors. I'm a doer. I bring people together. I'm inspiring. Look at my enthusiasm. I so believe in this.
I'm
not blowing smoke.
Well, so on a more personal note, my real estate coach is telling me, Brian, he wants me reading more books on leadership, like in terms of the focus of my business. What does leadership mean? What is good leadership?
Good leadership is enabling others to do amazing things. And what I know to be true is people support what they create. So the leadership that we need in the mayor, it's not about my ideas. I've got opinions and I've certainly done the research and the homework because that's something I do, Brian, right? I show up and I do the work. And you'll see that in my detailed platforms. When people do research, go on the website, jandamery.com, and you'll see the plan that gets us out of this. I know what to do. But leadership is enabling others, bringing people onto that, being willing to change your mind because you learned something new that you didn't know. We have not seen any of this indication of leadership by existing city councilors, particularly those two that are in the lead. We deserve better. And I'm offering my leadership. I don't have to do this. I have a great job, but I so believe in the city and it's going to take leadership, not politicians, to get us to where we need to go.
As you've gone down this road the last months and gone to, you know, many, I think, debates and such things. I heard you at the Calgary Real Estate Board debate. I tuned into that. And
what'd you fantastic. Think of that?
I enjoyed it. It was fantastic. And, you know, I learned some new things and it was really worthwhile, I thought. What are some of the things that you're seeing over and over again? Or is there something that maybe you didn't quite wasn't that maybe important to you when you started into this race and, you know, is now, like, what did you learn over these months?
You know, it's always amazing when you go into a new arena, right? And you learn what's on people's minds. I was struck by the complexity of sprawl versus density and how both of those terms are traps and actually pit inner city against outer city. And the answer is always, and we need choices in real estate. And you know this better than I, Brian, what people are looking for. We need amenity. We need to ensure that we're resourcing our neighborhoods equally, equitably around our city. So I hadn't appreciated the deficits that have existed. I mean, we have neighborhoods that were created, you know, in the 60s and 70s that we still haven't resourced properly. And we've got schools closing, I think in Scenic Acres, that are closing after 20 years because we're not regenerating these neighborhoods, yet we still go out and build more. We can do that, we have land, but there's an affordability question. And because people have been struggling financially, we're worried about taxes, we're worried about quality of services. And some of these services are under extreme stress as we try to recover this economy. So we've got to balance, but we've got to make sure people have choices. And we've got to understand and have transparency in our leadership. So it's not one or the other, and consult meaningfully with the people who live in neighborhoods. Our homes are personal to us. And to have something imposed at a larger regional area, I'm talking about the guidebook, of course, way offside. We need to do that over. We need to start with neighborhoods. We need to talk about the challenges. What would density look like in Altador? And I know this is a hot topic in our neighborhood because people don't like how the density is happening.
It seems people are kind of, in our own neighborhood as well, like Altador, Myrtle Loop, there seems to be a fair amount of, some people just completely against of maybe what's happening and others that are completely for it. Like, what's your stance on maybe, 33rd and 34th Avenue, sort of Myrtle Loop, Altador, and then maybe some of the fourplexes that we're seeing more and more, in our neighborhoods are tending to be on corner lots.
Yeah.
Right across the street from me recently, there's a bungalow that was sold and there was a development permit plan put in place. The builder would like to tear down the bungalow, put in two detached homes with garage suites on top of with garage suites. So it'd be four families living on that 50-foot lot. What are your thoughts on that in our neighborhood?
Yeah, I think if it's done well, because I think sometimes it's even hard to know if a duplex actually is a single home or not. Mm-hmm. People care about what things look like and want to feel that they're being heard. What they don't like is have large towers overlooking them, right? There's a privacy component. We want yards. We want, right? And we want to have access to amenity. But we've got to look at the balance of that in the entire region. I've been talking more about putting the towers, if you will, four stories or higher, on transit-oriented developments. You look at Westbrook, very close to us. You have a vacant field, but why aren't we building a lot of density there? You look at Mission, there's already tremendous density. So why are we looking to force neighbors? And they're afraid. They're afraid that we're actually going to do these big towers that just sort of impose and encroach. And so we can do density smartly. We can do density where it looks smart and is cool and keeps the character of a neighborhood. So so for me, it's always an and a balance. And let's sit down and talk about not either or, well, what would density look like and where would you want to put it? Where does it make sense? Because my reflection in COVID, one of the reasons I love Altador, I can walk almost for anything that I need. Walk or bike, that 15-minute city concept. It's healthier, which also means we have to make sure that we've got walkable neighborhoods, that there is amenities, and how we're sort of developing. But we've also got even a mid-ring of developments that don't have any of these amenities. You have to get in your car. And I don't know about you, but my kids are saying, I don't want to have a car. I want options to be able to actually take public transit and get anywhere. I want something to do in this city. So these are the things that I'm hearing. I want to be safe as we started out. So how do we engage people and engage in collectively solving the challenge rather than pitting each other against each other. Mm-hmm. And the city has to get out of the way of doing that.
Wonderful. Well, Jan, loving to hear your vision, loving to hear your experience over the last months. I want to take your time into consideration and our viewers' time. How else you got? We got 12 days. I want to share with you a couple of things, Jan, I've shared recently on social media, the power of mindset. And yes. So I'm wishing you the strongest mindset as you forge into the next 12 days of this campaign that I don't envy you on. But I want to thank you again for your standing up and agreeing to be our next leader. Yes. And I wish you all the best in that. Jan, what's the best way for people to, maybe say vote yes or help Jane in the next 12 days?
Yes, jandamry.com. But also there is a debate tonight that the Chamber of Commerce is hosting, 5:30. I think it's broadcast on Global. Tune in. You can get the link if you go on my website, jandamry.com/events. Donate, get a lawn sign, The election is not over, despite what you're reading in the polls. And what I always say about polling, there's only one poll that matters, and that's vote day.
Good. Well, we're wishing you all the best. And thanks again, Jan, for taking time out of this busy time for yourself.
Thank you.
We really appreciate it.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye now. Excellent. I just hit stop.